Hello and good morning, friends. Welcome to CEC-UGC Live Lecture. Dear friends, we would like to tell you all that today we are going to discuss on a very important topic, and the topic is the public relations and effective governance. We could say that how public relations plays pivotal role in effective governance. And for this, we have with us in our studios Honorable Director of CEC, Professor Rajbir Singh. Professor Singh specializes in the area of public relations, development communication, social marketing, and media research. He has authored a book titled Development Communication, Mass Media and Public Policy. As well as, I would like to tell you all that Professor Singh is an eminent scholar and has vast experience in mass communication. He has been guiding numerous researchers on various projects. As I have told you that today we are going to talk on public relations and effective governance. So before starting with this talk, I would like to tell you all that although different practitioners have given different definitions about public relations, according to the Public Relations Society of America, public relations is a strategic communication process that builds mutually beneficial relationships between the organizations as well as their publics. Public relation is also a practice of managing communication between an organization and its public. Now, again, the question arises when we are talking about public relations, how and important role it plays while governing. That is, when an organization use it as a tool of communication, how it helps the organization. So first of all, I would like to welcome our guest, Professor Rajbir Singh. I hope that with the help of his vast experience, we would be able to extract out maximum inputs which would be helpful for us. Welcome to the EDUSET lecture, sir.
Thank you, Girika.
As the topic itself suggests, public relation, and it's as we can say that it plays a pivotal role in effective governance. So we would like to ask from you how public relation plays an important role.
Yes, Gitika, thanks for good words, and good morning to viewers. And on behalf of CEC, I will say very happy new year to all the viewers. The topic for today's delivery is public relation and effective governance. How public relation play a pivotal role in governance, that is the topic for today's delivery. Public relation, first we need to understand what is public relation. There are numerous definitions about public relation. One of the definitions given by the Webster's New World Dictionary defines public relations as public relations with relations with the general public as through publicity, specifically those functions of a corporation's organization, etc., concerned with attempting to create favorable public opinion for itself. Under this definition, we find that public relation is a relation with general public. And interesting thing is that this relation is through, as defined through this definition, is through publicity, meaning thereby communication is at the core of the public relation. It is through communication that relations is established, and this relations is specifically for those functions of the corporations and organizations concerned with attempting to create a favorable public opinion in favor of the organization or the individual, for which the PR is done by any individual or any PR setup. A more specific definition which emphasizes the social responsibility is favored by public relation use. And what is that? The public relation is the management function which evaluates public attitude, identifies the policies and procedure of an individual or an organization with the public interest, and executes a program of actions to earn public understanding and acceptance. Here you find that public relation has been defined as management function. And this definition also indicates the role of PR in governance, because when we talk of management, the management is about governance. So here you can find, when we say that the public relation is the management function, meaning thereby public relation has a vital role to play in governance also. And what are those functions of the management to be called as public relation? Those are to evaluate public attitude, identifying the policies and programs with the public interest, and execute a program of action to earn public understanding. Again, the purpose of public relation is to earn understanding and acceptance of the policies and programs of the organizations. The following definition is also suggested. What is that? The public relation is a social philosophy of management expressed in policies and practices, which through sensitive interpretations of events based upon two-way communications with its publics strive to secure mutual understanding and goodwill. It's the same as we have discussed in the previous definitions. Now, going through these definitions, we came to the conclusion that there are the four basic elements of public relation. What are those four basic elements? First, it is a social management philosophy, meaning thereby public relation is a it's management social philosophy. It's the social philosophy of the management. Second, it is an expression of this philosophy in policy. It is the public relation finds its expression in the policies and decisions of the organization. And the third one is, it is action resulting from these policies. It is not only the policies and programs which matters, but the resultant actions out of those policies and programs which is important. That is why it is said that the public relation cannot merely build upon words, it has to be built upon deeds. Some action has to be there. Fourth, it is two-way communication that contributes toward the creation of these policies and then explain, reveals, defends and promotes them to public so as to secure mutual understanding and goodwill. So the fourth one is very important. As in case of the first definition we discussed, that establishing relations with the public through publicity. So it is communication which is at the core of the entire process of public relation, which is very important. Under the fourth element, you find that the public relation is a two-way communication. The communication in case of the PR is a two-way communication. Here we can differentiate PR with the advertising also, because in case of the advertising it's a one-way communication, but in case of the PR we have two-way communication. Feedback is also very important in case of the PR. There is another definition. According to the Public Relations Society of America, PRSA, the public relation, as while introducing, you said the public relation is a strategic communication process that builds mutually beneficial relationship between the organizations and their publics. So this very definitions, the use of the word strategic communication, public relation is a strategic communication. What it means that the communication in PR is planned, it is deliberate, it aims at something, aims at achieving something, and what is there in the name of achievement, that a favorable public opinion has to be, well, the purpose is to enlist the public opinion in favor of the organization. So it is strategic. When we say it is strategic, means thereby that the role of PR in governance is indicated through the use of this word strategic communication. And the other important thing is that the process, through the process of public relation, through this definition, it has also been emphasized that public relation is a process. It's a sustained effort. It's a long-term exercise. It's not a simple one-time communication. It is a continuous, deliberate and sustained effort on the part of the organization to establish and maintain mutually beneficial relationship between the organization and its publics. The PR setup is meant for creating a mutual beneficial relationship between the organization and its publics. Publics can be of two types. One can be internal publics, and there can be external publics also. There are four popular model of PR. The one model is press agentry, which is basically meant for publicity. Seeks attention of the organizations in almost in any way. That is the first model. That is also called the publicity model of the PR, where in one way or other way the organizations want to be in limelight, and for that publicity is used as an important tool by the PR person. And the second model is public information, that organizations simply passes on the information to the public and let the publics make their intelligence choice about the programs and policies of the organizations. That is the second model. Then there is a third model. The third model is two-way asymmetrical model, where the public practitioners conduct scientific research to determine how best to persuade publics to behave in the way their organization wishes. In this case, whatever the organization want to say about the organizations, the PR persons want to say about the organizations, they don't want to change, bring about change in the form of the feedback. Whereas in the fourth model, which is a two-way communication, third model is also a two-way communication where feedback is there, but the ultimate objective or the aim of the PR setup is to persuade publics in such a way that the organization's way is the organization's opinion is taken ahead. But in case of the fourth model, which is two-way symmetrical model, the practitioners brings about symbiotic changes in ideas, attitude, behavior of both the organizations and the publics through research and dialogue. In case of the fourth model, the publics influence the organizations, and the organizations also influences the public opinion. So in a way, one has a influence over the other, the other have influence over the organizations also. In this case, the organizations evaluating the attitude and the aspirations of the publics bring about some correctional changes in their programs and policies, and this is the fourth model of the governance, we can say. In case of the government PR, if you look into deep into these four model, you will find that the model 1, 2, 3, we have discussed four model. The first model, the publicity model, the second model is the public information model, and the third model is the two-way symmetrical model, and the fourth one is the two-way symmetrical model. In case of the government PR, normally we find the first three model, and the fourth one is seldom taken into practice. Now, we will talk about governance. What we mean by governance? The word government is derived from the Greek word meaning to steer, to take ahead. Koyman in 2006 provides an operational definition of governance. He states that governance can be regarded as totality of interactions in which public and private actors participate, aimed at solving social problems as well as providing socio-economic opportunities. Through this definitions, you will find that the governance means interactions of the stakeholders, be it public and be it private actors, they participate, and the participation is for the purpose of solving some social problems and providing socio-economic opportunities to the stakeholders. So the governance refers to the process of decision making as well as process of decision implementation. The meaning for the governance is in short, if you want to understand what is governance, the governance in nutshell is the process of decision making and the process of decision implementation. Now, what is good governance? Good governance is transparent, which is not opaque, accountable, management of human, natural, economic, financial resources for the purpose of equitable and sustainable development. In case of the good governance, it should be transparent, it should be accountable, and it is the management of the human, natural, economic, and financial resources for the purpose of equitable. Equitable means where everybody has equal opportunity. And sustainable development. The development model should be such that it should be long-term strategy. It should not be a short-term, but it should have a long strategy. The economic processes and administrative efficiency underlies the concept of the good governance. Bad governance may destabilize democracy, create unrest, civil war, freeze development, and leads to anarchic situations which nations would want to avoid at all cost. Good governance is not about institution of governance, but the governance. This is very important to understand. Good governance is not about the institution, is not something about organization only. It is about the governance. It is about the action. It is not only about the program and the policies. Sometimes the program and policies, how well-intentioned they may be the program and policies, but if the government or any organizations have not been able to turn translate into action, then program or policies or the doesn't carry any meaning unless and until it is translated into action. So good governance is about governance, how it is translated into action, how the stakeholders are benefited out of any program and policies. That is the parameter for the good governance. There are 8 important principles of good governance. The good governance, what kind of governance can be termed as good governance? If it is participatory, the stakeholders must participate. Unless and until there is no participation of the stakeholders, I think it will not lead to much results. So it should be participatory. Second, it should be consensus oriented. They all should come at a common point. There should be a consensus what should be done for the benefit of all. Then it should be accountable, as we discussed, that good governance, in case of good governance, it should be transparent. And it should be accountable. The governance should be accountable. And the another one important point is, as we discussed earlier also, the transparency, and it should be responsive. The governance, the system should respond to the need of the people. It should be effective and it should be efficient. It should reach to the last man. It should meet out the need of the poor people. And at the same time, it should be efficient and it should be equitable. The distribution of the benefit should be equally distributed. Every person should have equal opportunity. Then it should be inclusive. The growth for the people should be inclusive. It should not exclude one section of the society. The governance model should be inclusive in nature and follows the rule of law. It should be based upon the principle of law and the rule of the law. The function of the government PR. In case of the government PR, as we know that while discussing PR, we discuss the PR in government sector and the PR in the private sector, how the PR in the government sector functions. That is very important in case of the governance. because it assesses every section of the society. So in case of the while discussing the PR functions in the government sector, what are the various features of the what are the functions of the government PR? One of the important functions of the government PR is that it should uphold democratic values. The democratic values, the values as the freedom of speech, the expression, and the freedom of action. These are the democratic values, and the PRs, the government PR should uphold these democratic values. Then handling crisis and rumors. The other important function in case of the government PR is sometimes some rumor is there. Say some disease is there. There can be a rumor about the disease. So the important functions for the any government PR is to dispel that fear if any kind of rumor is there. So it is the responsibility or the basic function of the PR that the PR setup should put up the facts before the public, or so that they any kind of rumor mongering can be set aside. Similarly, handling crisis. If there is a crisis situation, some law and order problem is there, disaster is there, then in that situations, the right kind of information to the by the right people to the right kind of audience. This responsibility rests on the PR setup. And this way the crisis can be handled in a better way. Then maintaining transparency in affairs. How the government is functioning, what is going in so far as the program and policies concerned, how those programs and policies are implemented. So informing the public about the government actions. So that not only the government is supposed to act fairly and in a just way, but the system should appear to be just. That is also very important. And for this, I think a regular flow of information from the government side by the PR setup, by the government PR, is very important for maintaining transparency in the affairs of the government. Then connecting with stakeholders. The other important the function of the government PR is that the PR person by keep in touch with the publics of the organizations or the publics at large through different media or through different PR tools. There should be a regular connect with the people, because the relationship in case of the PR is built only through communication. So it is communication through which the relations are built. So a kind of a connect with the stakeholder is a very important function of the PR. Then persuasion. The element of persuasion is there in PR, because we discussed through different definition that PR is a strategic communication. So the use of the word strategy in the definition of the PR itself shows that it's a kind of a having a persuasive and planned kind of a efforts on the part of the PR. Then of course opinion formation is the important function of the PR, the government PR. Then promotion of the ideas, policies, and schemes. One of the important function of the PR to tell the stakeholders about the programs and policies, ideas, and schemes of the government to the stakeholders, or you can say the publics. We use the word publics in case of the PR. Then building honest image. Then we all know that this is very important function of the PR. The image building exercise is done by the PR. And the again, I would like to emphasize that this is all done through communication only. Then involvement, involving all stakeholders. The element of participation is highlighted through these functions of the PR. Then mobilizing support for the government, enlisting support of the government for popular schemes and programs of the government is another important function of the PR, and especially in case of the government PR. Then the another important functions I would like to say is analyzing, anticipating and interpreting public opinion, attitude and issues that might impact for good or ill the operations and plans of the organization. This is very important functions of the PR. Anticipating what is the mood of the public, what is the attitude of the public, and then analyzing it. And not only that, analyzing and anticipating the public opinion and attitude about the government policies and programs is also very important, because sometimes it helps in getting the feedback of the public, and it is this feedback which sometimes help the government in taking some corrective measures on some programs and policies which may be at one point of time may go wrong. So here the government can save itself by getting proper feedback. So this is very important on the part of the important functions of the PR, that is anticipating, analyzing, interpreting the public opinion, attitude and issues that might impact, maybe in the good way or maybe in a bad way, the operations and plan of the organizations. But this is very important functions of the PR, I would say. Then nature of the government PR. Earlier we discussed the four model of the PR. One is the publicity model, the other is the public information model, the third one was the feedback model, the asymmetrical information model, and the fourth one was the feedback model, where the two-way communication was there. Along with this, we need to understand the nature of the government PR. The basic nature of the government PR is of three types, that is informative. The government PR is the basic purpose is to inform the publics, then persuade the public, and the third one is so far as the nature of this PR is concerned, it is informative, it is persuasive and it is strategic. Informative means the purpose is to inform and to persuade, and strategic means it is intended with some object, to achieve some objectives. Stakeholders of the government. What are the stakeholders of the government? Public at large, press, pressure groups, NGOs, bureaucracy, political entities within country, global associations and groups, financial, social, cultural or regional, then nations, immediate and others, policy countries, then world bodies like UN and other world bodies. These are the stakeholders of the government, and any PR setup has to take into account these stakeholders, and in PR these are called the publics of the government sector, because in case of the PR, as I said, the publics, it can be internal as well as external. So as we discuss these stakeholders, they constitute the publics of the government PR. Then choice of the PR tools in the PR, in the government PR. In case of the government PR, the choice of the government PR is normally multimedia platform. Because in case the government PR is said to be the most complex kind of a exercise. And I think it's much, much difficult if we compare it with the private sector PR. Because in case of the government PR, the very publics which we talk about in case of the which we take in terms of the stakeholders, it is very diverse because it the PR has to take into account the diverse ethnic groups, the religious groups, different caste different reasons. So the government PR has to deal with a complex set of I would say the publics. So in to reach out that publics, he has to use multimedia platform, or you can say the media pluralism is the choice of the in case of the government PR. And along with this, it has to be a face-to-face communication, because all kind of a political communication in case of the, especially in case of the democracy, it has to be a face-to-face communication. The public meeting plays a very important role in case of the PR. And along with this, the traditional media, be it print or be it electronic, and now we talk of the new media. The new media has become a very handy tool. It has become a very important tool to bring about transparency in the government system. And the folk media is also used by the government PR, because when we say that India lives in villages, and folk media is a important, very important tool to reach out to the rural masses or the rural folk, because it's a live media and it's very close to the people. And when in case of the communication, you know, the effectivity of the communication will depend upon the liveliness of the media and the closeness of the media to the people. So being a live media, being close to the people, the folk media is also a very important tool used by the government PR. As I said, the new media has become a very important tool in the armory of the government PR. Because the virtual presence of the government is there with the Facebook, WhatsApp and Twitter and Instagram is there as a tool in case of the new media. And meaning of the virtual presence of the government is that the government has a direct face-to-face, not face-to-face, but direct contact with the public without any mediator, without the use of any media vehicle. Well, I would say without the, giving any ad in any newspaper or in any television, you can reach out to the stakeholders through Facebook or WhatsApp or in a more instant way, and in a response is immediate. And it is sensitive and sensitized media, and it's ubiquitous, it's available anywhere in any time mode also. So, and in case of the new media, the government is always connected with the people, and the instant feedback is there in case of the new media. You get a instant feedback also. And this new media acknowledgeable as opposed to the top to the bottom communication approach, where there is a hierarchical model of communication. But in case of a new media, you get a instant feedback in the form of the acknowledgement. Then governance at fingertips is there. It is said in case of the new media, the governance is at fingertips. We used to hear that Sarkar aapke dwar, But now the government is at fingertips. Just with a click of mouse, you will get all information about the government system. Narrow casting of the message is there in case of the this new media, and it's much approachable. And finally, I would say that in case of the new media, it has democratized the governance system. The new media has helped in a handy way to the government in democratization of the governance beneficiaries. Now the common people have more access to the government system through this new media tool. There is a German philosopher, Habermas, who has developed a theory of discursive democracy consisting of the informed dialogue between the people and the politician through the public sphere. Habermas finds that everyone who is concerned by a decision should have the right to participate in the debate about it in a free and equal environment based on universal rights. Meaning thereby, a public sphere is created where the decision affecting anybody, the stakeholder has every right to know about the decision. As we said, the governance, what is governance? Governance is about the process of decision making and implementation of the process of decision. So the every person who is affected by the decision, he has every right to know about the decision, how it is taken and how it is going to affect him. So a kind of a public sphere has to be created through the flow of the information, and this public sphere creation of this role of the creation of the public sphere is the role of the PR. So here we can say that PR has a vital role to play in case of the governance. And there is another theory, deliberative democracy. Deliberation is a learning process where new information which is revealed through the debate as well as new arguments permits people to transform their preferences during the process of deliberation. As they understand the question better, ideally the result is that only one solution, the best one, remains in the end, and that everyone agrees on that in consensus. Again, you will find that the deliberative paradigm offers as its main empirical point of reference a democratic process which is supposed to generate legitimacy through a procedure of opinion and will formation that grants A, the publicity and transparency for deliberative process, B, inclusion and equal opportunity for participation, and C, a justified presumptions of reasonable outcome mainly in view of the impact of argument on rational changes in preference. In case of this deliberative democracy, the deliberation is a meaning process where a new information which is revealed through the debate as well as new arguments permits people to transform. Meaning thereby, it is through deliberation that democracy is strengthened, and this deliberation is based upon the availability of the information, and this information is being provided by the PR setup. The flow of the information about the government policies or program so that people can discuss those policies and programs, and the people can take judicious decisions on those policies and programs. So this deliberative democracy is a concept, and this concept, the development of this concept is based upon the functions and the role of the PR in the democracy. Now we comes to the role of the PR, the significant role of the PR in case of the democracy. In case of the democracy, we say that democracy is the government of the people, for the people,
and by the people,
and by the people. When we say that democracy is a government of the people and for the people and by the people, meaning thereby that the people, the government of the people, meaning thereby the government, the democracy, in case of the democracy, the people, the political leaders are elected by the by casting vote of the people. So it is the people in case of democracy who are sovereign. They are the master. That's why we say it's the government of the people, and it is for the people, and it is government by the people. So in case of the democracy, it is the people who are the sovereign. They are the master. And if they are the master, then they have every right to know about how the government is functioning, how the government is working, the person who are running the show in the government, how they are forming their policies and programs, and how those policies and programs are translated into actions. So being the master, the people, being the master, they have every right to know about the government programs, policies, and of course vis-a-vis the action taken on those programs and policies. So we see that how the people will come to know about these programs and policies. It is the PR setup in the government which has this responsibility. The government entrusts this responsibility to the PR setup that they have make the public aware about the government policies and programs, so that they should be informed about the government programs and policies. So we see that in case of democracy, the PR has a very significant role. The role of making public aware about the government programs and policies, because it is their government, they are the master, and every master has a right to know what their servants are doing for them. Not only that, when we say that it's for the government for the people, meaning thereby whatever action is taken in the government, those are meant for the benefit of the public. So to make aware that public about those policies and programs, so that they can take benefit of those programs and policies, unless and until the public is told about those programs and policies, because some of the programs and policies, they may be complex, they may not be comprehensible. So to make understand public about the programs and policies, it is the role of the PR that they should make public aware about those programs and policies, so that they can take benefit of those programs and policies also. So in that sense also, the role of the PR is very significant in case of the democracy. And again, when we say that it's a government by the people, meaning thereby the government is elected by the people. In democracy, the government is elected by the people. How the government has functioned in the past 5 years, unless and until something is, someone is there, some setup is there to tell to the public that how the government has done or what the government has done for them, only then they will be able to decide about the fate of the government. Because again, I am repeating, it's the in case of democracy, it's the government of the people, for the people, and by the people. So in all three cases, since it's the government of the people, they are the master, they have every right to know about the program and policies, about the government functions. Then for the for the people, in case of that, they have every right to know the programs and policies. Not only they have a right, rather they should be told about those programs and policies, so that they can make their intelligent choices about the program and policies. Then finally, while deciding the fate of the government, they should be informed what the government has done so that they can take decision about the fate of the government also. So in case of democracy, the PR has a very important and very significant role in case of in governance. That's why we say that PR gains paramount importance in context of democratic government, which are publicly accountable to the public. Two-way political communication is a precondition for a society to harbor democracy. People need to be not only just informed and told, but also be convinced of the government policies, plans, procedures, and actions. So in the end, we can say that especially in case of the democracy, democratic government, the role of the PR is very significant, and in case of the good governance, the role of the PR is very vital. That's all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so very much for delivering such a nice lecture. I hope that all the students who might have watched us right now would got deep insight into this very topic, that is public relation, and how important role it plays in governance of a country or the organization. With this note, we would like to take your leave, and I hope that in future sessions also we would be inviting Professor Rajbir Singh, and under his able guidance we would be learning more and more. Thank you, sir. Thank you so very much.